The person who organized this evening is already transferred to the next world. So Be'ezrat Hashem, this lecture will be for the memory of his soul, to elevate his neshama, Le'ilui Nishmat, Le'iruven Shalom Ben Avraham, Nishmato Gan Eden. And I will not make a long lecture because I know it's Saturday night, Motzi Shabbos. But before I would start my lecture, first I would like to encourage everyone. Right here behind me, I brought you free CDs, courtesy of good, wonderful Jewish people who care for their brothers to see the truth. If you know me or you don't, all my lectures are based, most of my lectures are based on facts and proofs. It's a little bit unique because I'm not speaking just based on emuna, I'm speaking based on yediya, of knowledge, and proving that the Torah is divine, and then make life a lot easier for Jews to practice Torah. Because if a person has 10, 20, 30% doubt if his life is real, if he's following the right direction, it's very difficult to follow something, a list of instructions, when you have a doubt if you get paid in the end. If you go to work and all month you don't know if your boss is honest or is a crook, you don't know. All month, it's very hard for you to work because you think, what's going to happen at the end of the month? He's going to tell me you are fired and I'm not paying you. Very difficult to be a good worker. But if you got paid, next month you feel a lot better. Because you know, oh, that's legit. Very good. Now I have much more energy to follow the truth. So please have some CDs. You have here the Torah and Science, the famous film that I made a few years ago in English. It's a four-hour Jewish seminar. It's divided to three different sessions. First session is proving Mount Sinai, that Moses and God really spoke, and everybody heard the voice of God for the first and last time in history. It's about an hour proving it. How do we know for sure it happens? Not just a myth or a story somebody made up. Second part is all the divine information in the written and mainly in the oral Torah. Most of the proofs we show for many, many years in seminars all over the world, which are responsible for many thousands of Jews that they are observant of the Torah, is coming, believe it or not, from the oral Torah, not from the written Torah. The written also have plenty of proofs, but some people are criticizing the oral Torah or questioning the oral Torah. In reality, the oral Torah is full of divine information that leaves no doubt that a person can never write it. Only the creator of the world was able to. And the third part of the film is answering the most frequent question that every normal Jew or a non-Jew has in his entire life. Which means, what are we doing here? Why the world was created? Who is this God? What does he want from us? How do I know this life after life? What's the difference between us and the animals? What's the purpose of life? And how is the concept of reward and punishment works? How does the concept of the free choice work? How do I know I'm choosing what I do and I'm not just another robot? All these famous questions that I heard probably thousands of times, I answer them, everything in one DVD. And it's right behind me, you can have it, free of charge. Second, I'm making now MP3 CDs, which approximately 15 to 18 lectures on each one. For the car, for people who have cars from the last 4 years, most of them play MP3. You can play 25 hours of lectures in your car. It's also behind me. The last thing, I made a famous debate 3 years ago with a Christian professor, a teacher of Christianity of the University of Christianity in Manhattan. It's a 3 hour debate. Now we made it with Hebrew subtitle. Just came out a week ago. On a DVD, for those who don't speak such great English, it's all translated to Hebrew. So it's right here behind me. You can see how the Christian minister who teaches Christianity for 31 years, in the end of the debate, admitted that Christianity is false. So you put me in a hole, I don't know I'm going to get myself out of there. And I told him, I just proved to you it's a false religion. It's not a religion that was written by God. It's a man-made religion. He didn't say no. He say, my heart does not let me leave it. It was so good to me over the years, religion in general. It's very hard for me to disconnect myself from it. So I told him, the heart is all illusions, feeling, infatuations, dreaming. How can you know what's in your heart is the truth? We are talking facts here, not feelings. Feelings, most of them are false. We are talking divine proof. And I gave him an example. I say a Muslim terrorist, before he blow women and children and kill them for just because they are Jewish, he also believe in his heart all kinds of imaginations. What makes it valid? Does he have a proof? Can you prove that he's going to heaven for murdering innocent children? Of course not. It's against God's book. And the Muslims and the Christians admit that the Torah is a divine book. This is one of the hardest thing to digest. We have more than 4 billion Muslims and Christians combined in the world. None of them ever tried to deny that Judaism is the word of God. The opposite. They base their religion as a continuation of the Torah. So what could be a better proof that supposedly the enemies of Israel, of course not all of them are enemies, but in general Christianity was very, very anti-Jewish, with inquisitions and tortures and all, and Islam, just as bad. So they went after Judaism non-stop for the last 2,000 years, and they are the ones who admit with no hesitation. Of course God spoke to Moses. What's the question? Of course he gave him the Torah. Millions of people witnessed that. There's no question about that. We just claim that there is one more prophet. And we, the Jews, can prove 1,000,000% that it's all false. Every page in the New Testament, every page in the Quran, you bring me, I show you human errors. If God wrote it, what's happening to God? He forgets simple things that you and I remember, what is worse than us? How can it be? Just the person who made a statue and a minute later tell his children, let's bow down to the statue, this is our God. Let's hope that he's going to send us health and happiness and living. It's very foolish. You just made a statue, is a 1 hour old. He's going to bring you salvation to your life. It's very foolish. Foolish or not, hundreds of millions of people do it. What do you think? All the idols worshippers. It's hard to understand how does it work, but they bow down to all these idols in their temples, in India, in Thailand, in China. They're all worshipping idols. Go to Lower East Side, Chinatown over there. You see in the middle of the day, they have mincha. They put Buddha on the table and they all run around him and dancing with some, drums and this.